We'll get started by simply plotting the latitude and longitude of a flight trajectory for a single bird in a standard two-dimensional plot. Latitude and longitude are coordinates along the surface of a sphere, where a standard 2D plot is a plane, so we would expect very strong distortions for the flight trajectories. This is especially true because the trajectories cover a large spatial region. We are doing this, however, primarily to have a quick way to look at the data and develop more intuition about it. We'll be doing an actual cartographic projection later in this case study. We'll proceed with plotting, and we'll import our pyplot library as plt. We'll also import numpy as np, as is usual. One of the birds is called Eric. Let's extract the indices, the rows of the data frame, for Eric. BirdData.BirdName. We're looking for Eric in this data set. I'm going to store the indices in a variable called ix. Next, we'll extract the x and y coordinates of the flight trajectories. X and y are defined here as a tuple. I'll first get the longitude corresponding to my index, ix, and then I'll get the latitude for the same positions. And now we have our x and y coordinates here. I'm going to create a figure of whatever size is suitable, and then we'll plot the trajectories, x versus y, and in this case we'll be just using blue dots to represent the flight trajectory. Let's now look at a PDF version of this plot. In this plot, you can see the migration path that Eric has taken. Again, the flight trajectory will be substantially distorted because we did not implement any type of cartographic projection. Nevertheless, we get a decent sense of the flight path. Let's then plot the trajectories for all three birds in a single plot. We'll be extracting the bird names using pandas unique function. BirdData.BirdName. And we can now look at the contents of this object. And we have three birds, Eric, Nico, and San. Our code will be essentially the same what we had before, except that in this case we have to loop over all the three birds. My main loop is going to be for bird name in bird names. And I'll be making use of the code that we just wrote to fill the following lines. We'll proceed very much like before, except that when we define the index, instead of using Eric, we'll be using our generic bird name. We then extract the x and y coordinates. We'll move the figure establishment or figure creation to the very top, and then we plot the flight patterns. Once we are done, we can also add labels. Our x label is longitude, and our y label is latitude. Finally, we can insert a legend using plt legend, and we can specify the location of the legend. In this case, I'd like the legend to be in the lower right corner. So location log equals lower right. Let's try running the code. If we'd like to keep a PDF version of this, before we run the code, we want to make sure that we add the label for each plot. And in this case, the label is bird name. And we can now open the file. Looking at the plot, we see that all three birds seem to have pretty similar overall flight patterns. However, Nico and San seem to venture out further south than Eric does. We'll be looking at these trajectories in more detail in the tasks to come.